The scriptures teach us about marriage. And in the beginning, in Genesis chapter 2, verse 18, it says, it is not good that man should be alone. And then it continues and says, a man shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 11, we read, neither is the man without the woman in the Lord. And finally, in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4, we read, marriage is honorable. Our modern-day prophets teach us that marriage between a man and a woman, the family, is ordained of God. Marriage between man and woman is essential to His eternal plan. Successful marriages and families are established and maintained on principles of faith, prayer, repentance, forgiveness, respect, love, compassion, work, and wholesome recreational activities. And then we learn how to achieve a happy marriage, and it says, if you are married, remember that the friendship and love between you and your spouse should be your most cherished earthly relationship. Your spouse is the only person other than the Lord whom you have commanded to love with all your heart. Remember that marriage is in the truest sense, is a partnership of equals, with neither person exercising dominion over the other, but with each encouraging, comforting, and helping the other. Because marriage is such an important relationship in life, it needs and deserves time. Do not give higher priority to less important commitments. Take time to talk together and to listen to one another. Be thoughtful and respectful. Express tender feelings and affection often. Determine that nothing will ever come between you and your spouse to disrupt your marriage. Resolve to make your marriage succeed in spite of challenges that may arise. Be loyal to one another. Be faithful in your marriage covenants in thought, word, and deed. Remember that the Lord has said, thou shalt love thy wife with all thy heart, and shalt cleave unto her and none else. The phrase none else teaches that no person, activity, or possession should ever take precedence over your relationship with your spouse. Please take each other by the right hand. The other right. No, you're fine. You're good. You're good the first time. Right hand.
Like this?
Just like that. Just like that. Ryan Timothy Rambo and Jillian Marie Asay. You have taken one another by the right hand in token of covenants. You will now enter into the presence of God and these witnesses. Ryan Timothy Rambo, do you take Jillian Marie Asay as your lawfully wedded wife, and do you of your own free will and choice covenant as her companion and lawfully wedded husband that you will cleave unto her and none else, that you will observe all the laws, covenants, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish her as long as you both shall live? Jillian Marie Asay, do you take Ryan Timothy Rambo as your lawfully wedded husband, and do you of your own free will and choice covenant as his companion and lawfully wedded wife, that you will cleave unto him and none else, that you will observe all the laws, covenants, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish him as long as you both shall live? By virtue of the legal authority vested in me as the elder of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, I pronounce you, Ryan Timothy Rambo and Jillian Marie Asay, husband and wife, legally and lawfully wedded for the period of your mortal lives. May God bless your union with joy in your posterity and a long life of happiness together, and may He enable you to keep the sacred covenants you have made. These blessings I invoke upon you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may kiss each other as husband and wife. Congratulations. You have rings. We will now have the exchange of rings. That deserves one more kiss. Congratulations, both of you. We now present Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Jillian Rambo.
I'd first like to start with thanking Jill and Ryan for inviting me to be a part of their special day. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Emily, and Jill has been my best friend for the past 16 years. Jill and I grew up doing everything together. My mother used to tell me that we were the perfect match, because when I always had a really good idea, Jill would be the same one to tell me that it wasn't the brightest. Although, Jill had some pretty right ideas herself. Like the time nobody was home, so she thought it would be a good idea to take my mom's new lawnmower to drive us where we wanted to go. That same night, Jill finally understood the look from my mom as we came back with a mower covered in mud. Through our many adventures, good and bad, Jill's been by my side through them all. There are not enough words to describe what our friendship means to me. 16 years ago, God crossed our paths for a reason, and I cannot be more thankful. Ryan, I'm so glad to see the joy you've brought into Jill's life. As her husband, I understand that you'll be taking over the role of best friend, and I could not be happier to pass that on to you, because I know how much Jill loves you and that you'll take care of her. If everyone could please raise their glass, I'd like to congratulate the new Mr. and Mrs. Rambo. Here's to love, laughter, and a happily ever after. Congratulations.
Hello, everybody. You guys ready for like the best rap of your life right now? No, I'm just kidding. I'm not that good. I'm not going to make it on YouTube, but whatever. Okay. So I remember when I first heard about Jill, and I remember it because me and Ryan were seniors in high school, and we were in our after-school weightlifting group doing stair laps, just me and him. And I remember him starting to tell me about this girl named Jill, and he was super excited and infatuated about you, Jill, just so you know. But we're doing stair laps, and he starts freaking out because I remember it's the first night of them hanging out, and he says, Cody, you have to teach me how to kiss because I don't want Jill to think I'm a weirdo. So there we are. We're doing stair laps. It's just me and him, and we're talking, sweating profusely because we were both fat and out of shape back then. But I start putting my hand to my lips, like trying to do the motion of what you do when you kiss someone. But I love you. But obviously it worked out because they're here right now. So, but on a more serious note, there's a gap from when I first heard about Jill when they were dating in high school to when they just got back together in December. And there's kind of like that uncertainty there if they were going to make it back together again. And I remember having countless conversations with Ryan, just telling him that if they were meant to be together, that it would happen. And one thing that never changed that whole time was that Ryan never stopped loving you, Jill. And he is completely crazy about you. I would know from the many conversations we had together. But I'm just really glad to see that God decided to bring you guys back together. And on that note, I love you guys, and I wish you guys the best. So this is to you. Glasses up.
is called The Shoe Game. And in The Shoe Game, what's going to happen is they're both going to take their shoes off. They're going to give one of their shoes to the other person and hold one for themselves. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask them a series of questions, and they're going to answer it by lifting the shoe. For example, I'm going to ask them, who's the better driver? And they both agreed on the same person. All right, who's more creative? You can look and see, Jillian. He said he was. All right, who's more likely to destroy clothing in the laundry? Who's better at keeping surprises? Who's more adventurous? Okay. Who's more accident prone? Okay. Who's most likely to be running late? Hey. Who's the better dresser? Brian, listen carefully. Who's better looking? Jillian couldn't decide. That's great. Who said I love you first? And who made the first move? That's my boy. All right, who starts the arguments? And who's the first to say I'm sorry? All right, good man. Who has more shoes? Who's more grumpy in the morning? And who's the biggest baby when they get sick? Okay. Who is messier? Who's the better cook? All right, Jillian, you're gonna be happy. Okay, who's most likely to eat dessert for breakfast? Nice. Cheesecake for tomorrow morning, right? All right, who makes all the decisions? See? All right, who's always right? And she very definitely rose her own shoe there. Yes, I'm right. Who's the shyest? Who had the best wedding ideas? Keep it up. Who's the better singer? Gillian? You ready to prove it? Oh, okay. Who's the better dancer? Okay, he says himself. You ready to prove it? Okay, right after this. Here's the last, almost last song. Who do you love more than anyone else in the world? All right, very good. You guys put your shoes back on. Great job, guys.